A common question I get from technology leaders and executives is, when do I know my machine learning solution is ready for use? What accuracy should I be satisfied with? 95%? 85%? In this video, I share four questions on how you can shift the conversation from a pure statistical number to a business value, and how you can see this with a new lens to take that critical decision on when you should start using your algorithm. Let's start with a scenario. You have decided to implement machine learning to classify your support tickets. You have users raising thousands of tickets and you want to see whether they fall into the HR, finance, or IT bucket. And you want to use a model for that. You give it to your data science team. They work on it for 2 months and come back and excitedly make a presentation. They show how the model is able to do stuff well. And everything goes all right until the accuracy conversation comes up and they proudly say that the model is at 78% accuracy. And that's when all hell breaks loose. So there are questions on whether the model can be any better. Why does it make so many mistakes when we have AI around us? Are the model building process, the skill level of people, is it good enough? So all of these are conversations which get sparked. So there should be four questions you should instead ask before you worry about the 78%. Question number one, what is the human error rate? So it's common to assume that humans are able to do it perfectly, a given task. But given the volumes and the fatigue factor and the skill level of the team staff, there is likely to be an error rate. Let us say you measure it and you find out that it is at 80%. So now this becomes a comparison. You have a benchmark to look at. 78 versus 80 as opposed to 78 versus 100. The second question you should ask is, what is the future upside? So can the model get any better? Can it go up to 90% in a year? Maybe it can. Whereas humans, with some upskilling, you'll get them to 82%. So now the comparison is 90 versus 82. You start getting a clearer picture. Algorithms, when they see more data, they get better. With advances in machine learning research, they get better. And when your skill level of your team building the algorithm goes up, this is likely to improve. The third question you should ask is, do I have the option of keeping humans in the loop? And how can I bring in this synergy? So when you have 78% as accuracy, there will be certain scenarios where the model is pretty good. It is at 95%. Whereas in some cases, it is at 65%. So now, when you replace the model in these scenarios with the human, then 95 plus 80, you probably will end up with 85%+ accuracy to even start with. So this is a much better result than either this or even this. So that's where, when you have human in the loop and design the solution in such a way that you combine both, it can be very powerful. The fourth and final one, a very important one, is to ask the ROI question. We've had conversations about the percentage, but what does it even mean? What is the incremental revenue I'm getting? What is the cost saving I can get? Increase in performance. So when you take all of these and translate those into dollar numbers, what does it look like? What does it look like today and in the future? Because this is a much better conversation than purely talking about percentages. And this is a question you should ask your data scientists as well. What is the outcome that you're delivering me? Can you guarantee that you give me a better dollar value as opposed to just gaming the percentage? And this shifts the internal conversations perspectives of the entire organization, and you can hold them accountable to this. So these are four ways that you can shift the conversation from a statistical one to a business value driven one. Hope you found this useful. What other questions do you ask, and how have you shifted the conversation in your organization? And how have you gotten value from machine learning efforts, and particularly the algorithm accuracy? Do share in the comments. Thank you.